Welcome to your in present years. I'm going to present the topic will be called as straightness and flatness measurement by Sheila Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Civil Engineering College, Tandem, Chennai. This beam's level is understand. So we're going to see, now we're going to see for the straightness measurement. So a line is said to be straight or over a given length if the variation of the distance of its from two planes perpendicular to each other and parallel to the general direction of the line remains within the specification tolerance limits. The tolerance on the straightness of a line is defined as the maximum deviation in relation to reference straight lines joining two extremes in the line to be checked over here. So this is the one here, this is the allowance deviations. This is straightness for the one. This is the reference line. So this is maximum limit, and then the limit will be used for the one to you to check the straightness of the measurements. So as a straight edge is a measuring tool, so which consists of length of the length of a steel of a narrow and a deep section of these in order to provide a resistance to bending in a plane of measurements without a excessive weight. For checking the straightness of the any surface, the straight edge is placed over the surface and two are viewed against the light with clearly indicate the straightness. That gap between the straight edges and the surface will be negligibly small for the perfect surfaces. So straightness is measured by observing the coloring light, the difference between the passing through the small gaps for the one. This is the color light, red will indicate the gap between the 0.012 and 0.0075. So this kind of an will be an this when you go to cross this limit of variation, so the straightness won't be in perfect one. So autocollimator is device which is already know that you used to measure the linear movement. It's also we used to can measure the so straightness. You can even usually see the tone. So this autocollimator, this is line of the straight. So been able to measure the tone. So where can able to meet the so straightness for the tone. So how much straightness is there? So using this device, you can able to easily measure that one. So, because of height, then this that variation you can able to, the deviation you can able to easily measure using autocollimator adjustment. So, for the flatness, so test for the one you can able to easily possible to compare the surface with an accurate surface. The method is suitable for small places, not for the larger surfaces. The recommendation mathematical calculations will be there for the simple methods. You can able to easily calculate for the flatnesses. So here for this one, there for the flatness testing for the one, so you can able to take the one for the randomly points. So where that flatness for the one, so measure the places and then you can able to easily measure that for the one. So this is for the exceptional for the one. This is for the maximum value, and then for the one maximum positive value, the minimum value. This is for height of the detail over this form. This is the datum of the projections for the all the x1, y, and z direction I can able to miss over here. So this is the for the tone you can able to calculate over there. So inlets A, B, A, D, and then B, D cut to the according to the cut it to 0. So based on the A, B, C, D is said to be 0 here. This is A, D, and then A, B, and then the B, C, and then C, D. So all this. So the height of the points I is determined applied to the ABD equal to 0 is for the tone. So A, B, and then D is set to 0. The point C is fixed to the relevant appropriate plane. The points BD as set to 0, and then intermediate point BC and then DC as cutted to the accordingly. First, you want to set the tone. So B and then D is set to 0. And the main thing is that the BD and DC will be cutted. Question of H and G and E and F also known. So it is now we can possible to fit the G and the F. this also provides a check on a previous evaluation, since the midpoint of the line should be coincide with the position of the midpoint of the eye. So in this way, the height of the point of the surface element to the CBD is known. Thank you for watching this video.